Hey guys, welcome to the third installment of Hosty's Game Time with your host, Jacob. We've got Big Zano on today. I'll let you introduce yourself.
Hey guys, Zane Bijorac, play for the Sydney Rabbitohs.
Nice, mate. You hungry?
Always, sweet. Mate, always.
All right, we'll get some menu log because I'm starving. We had a big day today, so we'll jump on and grab. What's your go-to order usually?
Probably a bit of Guzzi Gomez, I think.
Guzzi Gomez?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. All right,
sweet. I'll see what I can find. How do you feel about chicken wraps?
That'll do.
Oh, chicken sandwich. Yeah, what's your go-to like cheat day meal?
Cheat day meal, oh, that's tough.
Probably he doesn't have cheat days, this bloke. Have you seen him with a shirt off?
No, probably just a snack
single
pack.
Ladies, any single ladies out there? Because he is a snack.
Nah, just a snack pack with a bit of barbecue garlic sauce on top.
The Holy Trinity, surely?
Yeah, no.
You don't go the Trinity?
No.
Okay. That's another level down. All right, beautiful. That's done. All right, let's get into it.
Beautiful.
So what team are you going with today?
The Ravens, Baltimore.
So yep. You're going with the cheese team. I've stuck true to my team, the Carolina Panthers. My boy Christian McCaffrey.
Nah, my boy Lamar. Better calm it up.
You're not a real Ravens fan, let's be honest. I'm definitely not playing Sam Darnold. He is not getting much game time today. So Ravens, your actual team?
Yeah, I watched that a little bit, just mainly because I had a mate that got me onto Lamar and I just watched all his highlights and I just thought,
he's a freak,
it's pretty impressive, yeah, yeah. Pretty entertaining, so.
He had a tougher year this year, but
yeah.
But like, that's to be expected.
One man team, mate.
But I was watching it. So I remember I never used to be into NFL, and then one year I got into, you know, like those fantasy comps.
Yeah, yeah.
So I got into that, and money on the line makes you get a bit more interested in.
Yeah, that's where you learn all the players and everything.
Yeah, and then like since then, literally, I'll watch the NFL every time there's a game on. It's so good.
Yeah.
That's a terrible kick. All right, boys. Big D set here.
Oh yes! Woo! What a start! He's rattled.
Oh, darn.
Touchdown!
I forgot the controls.
Yes, baby. Yeah,
I'll juke it.
So we've been in his head. The Carolina Panthers are on the board. Let's go.
That's not how you want to start.
That's an absolute Barry Crocker.
Here we go. Now, are you going to choose a player or warmer? So just, we were saying this before, when I play Madden, I've missed this.
Oh, sneaking
in. Oh, he's just got it.
When I play Madden, I never play defense. I literally go like...
Just all offense.
All offense career mode. Like, so I'm just...
Yeah, no one wants to play defense like...
No. No one wants to play defense. So now we're going to try the kickoff again. We'll send it exactly the same. Down the right. See if we can get another fumble. Zane is rattled.
Controls.
So, Zane, where is your like heritage? So obviously your last name,
Bijorac. Yeah, yep. So it's Serbian.
Yep.
So my dad's side of the family is all Serbian. Been over there a few times to play for them.
Have you?
Yeah, yeah.
So you've actually been to Serbia? That's mad.
Yeah, 2018. I went over there for the 19s tournament.
Yep.
Played for them. And yeah, that was a good experience. That was the first time I went. Played with a few of my mates from back home as well. And then went back there about 2 years ago now for the men's, for the World Cup qualifiers, yeah.
Nice. Versus Greece. Did Serbia qualify for the...
No, we didn't, so we versed Greece. So that was Pete Mamazoulis and that. And
did you have to verse Pete in that?
Yeah, yeah. Pete's pretty funny to verse because he's just not a funny guy.
I was just trying to lay to him
and everything, yeah.
He's savage.
But all good now.
That's pretty cool, man. I didn't realise you'd been back over there and that. That's awesome. So you got like a real good connection with your culture and heritage, eh?
Yeah, for sure. I might try to go back there even in the off season this year. So
if is it, borders are back open now, aren't they?
Yeah.
So you can go back over.
Yeah.
Do you have family over there?
Like, distant relatives? We didn't. But when I went there the first time, we sort of went to where like my bubba was from and in the countryside. Yeah. So it was pretty cool to see. But
That's mad. So that's where the nickname Baba Ganoush comes from?
Yeah, mate, yeah. Got the Baba tattoo with the Orthodox cross on the chest. That's so sick.
Yeah, so for those that don't know, there was a trip back from, there was a reserve grade game, and Zane, being Zane, didn't hesitate to take his shirt off and show off all his tattoo, the Baba Ganoush tattoo. Because he's, if you don't know, again, once again, single ladies. He's a single man living in the Cronulla area. He was trying to fish,
there,
he was trying
there.
To fish on Instagram yesterday. He wasn't doing a great job, so I help him out with that. You're absolutely marching me down the field here. Get up, son!
No.
Woo! Oh. Mate, I'm telling you, I'm a freak at this game. I don't even play defense. Swap. I don't even play defense.
That was ordinary, bro. I was playing the slow go-on game there.
Mate, don't let me get in your head, because once I'm in there, it's hard to get rid of me.
It's hard to get out. Mate, how do I swap my defense, like my players?
He's rattled. He's dead set rattled. After the interception, here's Darnold. Run, son.
You're not catching him! You're not catching Robbie Anderson, baby! No. He's gone!
That's all right. I didn't want to defend anyway. I'll get the ball back.
One play, that's all it takes. That's all right. I'm being
I'm rusty, I'm rusty.
The mic, aren't I? Alright. So we've both had a bit of a mishap to start the season.
Yeah.
You've hurt your knee, and then I have recently done my shoulder with rehab buddies. How's your rehab going? Can you run us through how you're progressing and when we can expect to see you back?
Yeah, it's going well. So I had surgery, it'd be about 3 weeks now.
Yep.
Post-surgery. So the surgeon said it can be up to probably 8 to 10 weeks. So it's coming along really well. It's feeling stronger every day.
That's good.
It's actually been good to sort of get a bit of off-feet conditioning as well. I'm feeling pretty fit.
Mm-hmm.
So just keep going at it, and hopefully around 6 weeks, 5-6 weeks,
I think I'll be back.
Yeah.
It's a good opportunity. Like, people, like, obviously being injured sucks, but it's a good opportunity to get your body right. Like, obviously having a big pre-season start of the year, your body's a bit bashed up, but you can get that fitness in, you can get that strength in without having to go out and just clang and bang every day.
Yeah.
Which is good. So
100%. So just trying to look at the positives, man. Yeah.
Oh man, that's a terrible kicker. So yeah, as you say before, playing against like Pete and that when they played for Greece, you've sort of come through the grades playing with the younger fellas and now in the top 30 with you. How's that been, that journey, and having like familiar faces with you coming up through the grades?
Yeah, well, it's been awesome. Like, obviously, it's been a few boys I've played with for a while now, Ben Lovett. My actual, how I first got into South, I had a trial at, I think, Canterbury Oval when Ben Lovett was actually in the trial as well, and we sort of got someone in the same game. So
country boys.
Yeah. So I've sort of always seen him around and that.
Yeah. Because
so
you're from Canberra originally?
Yeah, well, I'm from Queanbeyan. Yeah. Went to school in Canberra and that, but yeah, Queanbeyan boy originally, so.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah.
And then in the big smoke.
In the big smoke, mate, yeah. Loving it. That's the play I want. Bang.
I didn't see the play. Oh no.
I've been looking for this play for so long.
Getting off the edge here. Get around. Boom! Oh,
he's almost thrown another pick. Deary me.
So now that you've been around the boys for a little while now, get to see the personalities. If you're too scared to say who you think it is, but we all know who it really is, who's the most annoying in the club?
Well, someone I probably look for when we're doing video that'll just probably pester me is probably Cody. Like, you're always going to get a flick in the back of the ear or just something like that. And then you look back and he just tries to look away. It's like, it's always just going to be him. So I'd love to say him in video, but yeah, most of the boys are pretty good though. Yeah, no one's too much of a pest off.
No, so he's really taken the mantle since Reno left, hasn't
yeah,
he?
Yeah.
And then some as well.
For sure.
Speaking of like the video sessions, how good is it when you have big Tommy, who always, old 2 cents Tommy, he's got to have a comment on everything, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's always got an opinion, eh?
He's got plenty of knowledge, the big fella. He's been around the block a few times.
Even like his locker's pretty close to mine, so I'll just be sitting there talking to Josiah or just anyone, and like you can sort of see him just in the background like listening, and then he'll just Oh, yeah, he'll just always have an opinion on whatever you're talking about.
He's great for morale, Big Tommy. I love the big lad.
Yeah, and it's even better now, like, because I was saying where I just moved into.
Yeah.
And he was like, oh, you know, I'm only down the street a bit.
Yeah, he is.
I was like, oh. He's got a good place. Around the area. Yeah.
Mate, you'll be a local in no time. You'll get to know everyone. You'll be a shy boy. The shy crew's growing. It's good to see. I'm about to hit stick this absolute shit out of
you. Go, Lamar.
No! He's so fast. Oh, down the sideline. Oh, how arrogant are you?
I didn't even mean to do that.
All right, so this is for the extended cut. This is not going to be found on the Whoops House website. No. Tell us about the little incident outside of Clovelly Hotel. I think it was the Christmas party of 2020. We just had a big pre-season session and obviously had a couple of beverages in the belt. Can you tell us, run through the play-by-play, what happened out the front of Chloe Hotel? He's just trying to unpick.
No, thank God. So obviously it was my first pre-season done, first sort of few months around the big boys. It was coming to a wrap and I was just very excited to have a few beers, I think. Obviously started off at the Maroubra Beach Club, had a few there, had a bit of a punt, was feeling good. Some things led to another, had a few more beers. And then I don't know whose idea it was, but someone said, oh, we'll go to Coogee. And I was like, oh, all right, and we're sort of struggling to get in places because there were so many of us. I was just crossing the road in Coogee there, and then someone's decided sort of to clean me up a bit, and then I've sort of went up on the bonnet there and jumped down, and you know, obviously I've had a few beers, so I'm feeling all right. And our mates jumped out sort of fearing for me, and I've just sort of said, oh, don't worry about it, mate, I just want to get to the pav. So I've scraped it off and just went up to the pav.
I did a flip over the car.
Yeah, did a flip. And then the next day I sort of woke up with a few more bruises than I thought I had. Down the collarbone or whatnot. It's one of them stories that
gotta be every time he tells a story, the car gets bigger. So it was originally just a Toyota Corolla.
Yeah.
But now when he tells
there's a few different
Ford F-250.
Yeah, there's a few different interpretations of how it happened too. I say it was at a crossing, so it wasn't my fault, but a few of the boys said that it was my doing.
That's insane. That's honestly insano Zano. He's found another pick!
Oh, is that a touchdown?
No way.
What? Yes.
Alright, you gotta get up and
Let's
do his
dance. That is the worst touchdown.
That is the worst touchdown I've ever conceded. I don't even know. I thought you were trying to catch the ball, man.
Bro, on the board. I'm rolling now.
Man, I remember when that happened. I've never been in so, like, initial shock.
Yeah, I know.
And then to literally feeling like I was going to, like, piss my pants laughing.
It was one of them situations, like, you didn't know whether to laugh or, like...
Didn't know. And then you literally just bounced up.
But, like, I was fine. I was just too excited to go to the next place to even care.
Tough as nails.
Insane. I wasn't the next day. I woke up the next day. Because I think we had the Christmas break.
You had plenty of time to recover.
It took me about a good week to recover from the bruises and whatnot.
You'd have been that embarrassed, surely, in front of all the boys.
Me? I was just happy I got a good story.
Yeah, great story. So you played, you got your first sort of taste with the top grade this year up in Towns, or in Cairns, sorry, against the Cowboys in the trial, and you got over the stripe. How was that feeling? And obviously, how was the game? Obviously, getting that first little taste.
Yeah, well, obviously it was unreal. Like, it was a good experience going up to Cairns. I've never been there before. It was pretty tough in the conditions, the hot weather and that. Yeah, but
especially that time of the year.
Yeah, but no, it was awesome. It was awesome to get a run with the boys and obviously get a full game in and whatnot. So felt good sort of when I crossed the line, and just, you know, I was a bit nervous beforehand, but once sort of the game started, I was pretty sweet. Yeah. So I'm not too much of a nervous person usually, but yeah.
That's good. And then you scored a try, so did you have any try celebration in mind that you wanted to show?
Nah, well, I don't think I've ever really celebrated when I've scored a try. It's just
straight face changes.
But I think I was a bit excited there, and I sort of flicked the ball up a little bit, and I was like, a few of my mates message you like, oh, what are you doing there? So I don't know, it was just a heat of the moment type of thing, I guess. But
should have just flexed. It worked every time.
Nah, I don't think I did enough to.
Is there like a punishment if you take your shirt off and flex? Like, you know how in like you play in the EPL and that, they take their shirt off, it's instant yellow card. Is there something in in footy? Like, if you do that, you're in trouble?
I don't know. I reckon they should surely not. Hey?
Surely not. Let the boys play.
100%. Because what's that? What is there a round where it's the try celebration?
Yeah, yeah, try July.
Yeah, that's surely, like, a few boys getting the rig out for that.
Honestly, it'd be rude if you didn't.
A couple like Conor McGregor or something.
Conor McGregor, that's what Tane had last year.
Is it? Yeah.
Yeah. Mate, you're in trouble here. I've got exactly what I want. Boom. I haven't got what I want. Yes, I do. No, I don't.
Oh, bang.
He doesn't got the arm.
Bang.
So, obviously, as we've said, you're in the top grade this year. Do you have any goals for the season?
Well, obviously, coming into preseason, I just sort of wanted to smash that, get as fit as I could, and I feel like I did a good job there. Obviously, it doesn't help. A bit of a setback during playing 20s, but obviously, just get back to... good start. Just getting back to being healthy again, and then probably the first few rounds back, just playing good footy, and then seeing where it goes. Obviously, I played a few cup games last year, and I felt pretty good doing that. I enjoy playing men, so... Just getting to that, and then just seeing where I can sort of go, and just playing good footy, and then I guess the coaches will decide where it goes from there.
Yeah, nice, bro. Have the coaches got you working on anything particular, obviously, before you got injured?
I think just sort of my direction off shape
would
be the main thing. Obviously, that's a big difference to 20s, where you can just freelance a little bit and do your own thing.
Yeah.
Where you get to a top grade, you sort of have to have a bit more structure to be effective. So,
yeah, state of the game.
Yeah, just my positional play and where I'm standing and the lines I'm running.
It's
good,
bro. We've got it. Man, this guy's—he's smart, mate. I'm telling you, the man with the plan.
Man with the plan.
Is there anyone at the club that you sort of look up to, or you sort of lean on for a bit of advice in your position?
Well, someone I probably look up to, just in regards to how they train and how they conduct themselves. I think even last year when I did the preseason, it was definitely Cam.
Mm.
Just very professional, how he goes about his business. But then in regards to my position, probably big Stretch. I think, seeing just how he's improved through the years.
The two assassins.
Yeah, so that's
Stretch is the killer and Zane's the Serbian assassin.
Yeah, so pretty similar in that regard, just not too many smiles, I guess, but big Stretch, probably, yeah.
Big Stretch, he's the man.
Just quietly, I've taken the lead as well.
Yeah, we'll keep that quiet. I'm in trouble here. Oh, I can't afford another fourth and out. Oh, three and out, whatever it is.
I'm going to keep that dead again, eh?
Yeah, we'll take the 25 yards. Thank you.
Pretty much handing it to you.
Mate, you're playing with the Ravens, mate.
What's that mean?
What do you mean?
I don't even own a PS5. Like,
you just I'm having a look at the shapes
and that.
I've got Sam Darnold at quarterback. You've got Lamar. You've got about 30 options with one player.
That's right, this is about to go to the house, baby. Oh, no, it's not.
Oh, that's a sack.
Go, son! Yes, big Lamar Darnold.
Fumble. Oh. The worst is when you run with your QB and they just fumble it.
They fumble
so
it because they just got hands with butter on it.
But Lamar's actually pretty good, like, cause I think just because he runs so much in actual game.
I love how in the crowd they've got like all the same people doing the same animations.
Yeah.
They're just like, yes.
Watch this.
Look at the rush from the left edge. Pressure's on here. Got him.
Nah.
Oh, my.
Pick.
Touch him, mate. Oh.
Bro, give me some swagger.
I can't lose another game on my own show. I can't be going, oh, man. This is not good.
Slow it up, dude.
We have to have a big defensive set here. Big defensive set. I'm going to bring
it
the pressure.
It would be bad if you
bring
lose this set, I reckon.
If I lose this, I don't play this game that much, but
I'd probably sell the console.
Were you looking to buy it? Maybe. They're worth much money.
I bought one for a week and then I sold it, hey.
Boom! So we're distracted with the conversation. Yeah. It works every time.
Smart.
Wait, they're worth like, people are buying PlayStation 5 secondhand for like $1,200 in that.
Yeah, well, that's what I did. I bought it for like that much as well. But then I sold it.
Wow, it's smart. You would have sold it for like $1,500, surely.
Nah, I think I just broke even. I had like a week or two of entertainment and then just...
Did you get sick of it?
Yeah, I don't know.
Bro, I got so lucky that... Oh, no.
Go, son.
How many breaking tackles? I got so lucky that I pre-ordered it.
Yeah.
And then when the release came, they called me up and they were like, yeah, sweet. We got you one. it'll be here on this time at 6 o'clock in the morning. I was like, don't worry, I'll be there at 5:30.
Yeah, that's it.
You're in trouble, mate. You're in trouble. Game over. That's half time.
Oh, is that half time?
What a waste of a play. He doesn't have any clock management.
That's all right. Got the lead, can't complain.
Half time, 1 point lead, mate. You had an absolute shocking start to the game. All right, are we hungry? I'm starving.
Let's eat.
So, is menu log here yet? Oh, yes, it says it's here. All right, you got to do a little menu log dance. So when the food comes here, you got to be like a little happy dance.
A little happy
and
dance.
I'll sing the song. This is how we do it. You got to get up and dance, bro.
Like what?
This is how, anything.
All right.
This is how we do it.
When the bag comes?
It's here. It's here. This is how we do it. All right, there you go, mate.
Beautiful.
Tuck in. We had a big day at training today. Our rehab coach, Jared, absolutely towed us up on the bike today. So
no, I was on the ski.
Oh, big Zano.
He's on the ski.
So he's got the best workout noises.
Yeah, a few moans.
Hell yeah. Yeah. So what sort of exercises they got you doing for rehab with like a knee? For anyone else that's out there that's got a knee problem, listen up.
So just at the moment, mainly trying to get some strength back in that quad.
Yeah.
Because obviously the surgeon's opened up two sides of, I don't know what that bit's called, but my kneecap's one of them, and obviously I've lost a lot of strength in the quad there.
Yeah.
So just trying to make sure I can get the range of motion, straightening the leg, and then just regaining strength there, so.
That's a big thing at the moment, eh? Like, first thing, like, you want to get that range back.
Yeah, so, and then obviously once I get that, I could start putting a bit of load and weight back into the leg, so. Yeah. I mean, they're not the biggest legs in the world, so.
Hey, they do the job, mate.
They do the job, mate.
It's actually a really nice sandwich. Mm. A fantastic job.
That is good.
Hey. Yeah. I've got two questions really. Or three. I've got three.
Maybe if you want just like general questions, you can just talk about like other hobbies outside.
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
And just even like what you watch on TV, movies as well.
Yeah, man. I'm a bit of a mover.
Yeah, what
maybe also
okay.
With those kind of boys as well.
Yeah, like with the younger boys, yeah?
Yeah, because I think that's interesting.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So yeah, you can talk about your journeys together even through the younger grades and any fun stories you may have.
Do I keep this here?
Maybe you can keep eating it or you can just leave it.
I literally just had like a wrap just before. I'll eat it after, but
no, take you don't
two. Alright, just keep it here then?
But yeah, just keep it there.
Alright, yeah,
we'll continuity.
Alright, yeah.
Maybe Hosty, you move your bag onto the
side. Gotta win this game as well.
I'm trying not to make a mess, but I'm doing it again.
Two pair sandwiches
and hot. Yeah. I need a buffet or something.
I've been going.
I need to get a Hosty's game time bib.
You do.
Get one made.
Or at least like a big napkin.
Yeah.
Have I been going alright?
Yeah, they're good.
So you want to talk a bit more about, so you said before, in that trial game with Benny Lovett.
Mm.
Do you want to talk a bit about more about both your journeys coming into to South?
Yeah, well, I think he was playing for Parks. We both played in the same country comp, so I forget what it's called, but it's the New South Wales sort of country comp.
Mm-hmm.
And we both played the 18s, and I was lucky enough to make the New South Wales side out of that. Mm-hmm. And then I think he did the year after. So we both got a contract at the same time. Yeah. He was sort of one of the blokes I started, I guess, like, talking to first. I was just shy, didn't know any of the boys, another country lad, so sort of thought I'd make friends with him, and yeah, sort of haven't stopped seeing his face since, unfortunately. Some days I wish I could, but yeah.
Do you have any napkins? I'm a mess. This is so bad. There should be something just behind. Thank you. It's all the avocado.
They do
the
look like the sandwiches, I ordered them. Oh man, I'm hungry.
They're fantastic. They do an awesome job.
Okay,
so You're a bit of a movie buff, you're saying. What's your movie? Your favorite movie of all time, favorite movie of this year, and what TV show are you currently binging?
My favorite movie of all time. That's a tough one, eh? I'm into like a lot of thrillers and science fictions. All time, I like Interstellar with Matthew McConaughey.
Absolutely great movie, great actor.
Yeah, even like your Inceptions, DiCaprio, stuff like that. Everyone's a bit of a Brad Pitt fan, I guess.
Well, you're sitting next to him, so.
A few of my old times. Even like Back to the Future and some old ones.
The throwbacks, yes. Yeah, I love the Back to the Future movies.
So this year, trying to think of what I've seen this year, the movies. There hasn't been too many movies I've been sort of wowed by this year, I think, when I've been in the movies, but.
Have you seen that June? Have you seen that?
Yeah, that was all right. I watched that twice.
Did you?
Twice and watched that. Yeah.
Must have been good.
I'm trying to think what other movies I've seen this year.
Bro, I was dead set, like, go to the movies at least once every 2 weeks, if not every week. I'm there, like, all the time. It's my favourite thing to do, excuse me, if I have free time.
Yeah. TV shows.
Surely you got plenty of TV shows.
As I said, there was this
Law
one.
Law & Order. Hey? Throw back to Davey, Law & Order.
Law & Order, man.
That's his go-to show.
I watched this one, this real weird one on Netflix once, and it was called Dark. It was like a science fiction. Yeah, it's a full, I think it's German and it's got subtitles and everything. But like that's just the type of stuff I'm into.
Like, are you like the out there stuff?
Yeah, well, that's pretty out there. But then I'm also like, you know, I watch Euphoria and all them sort of shows that are pretty mainstream. But
have you ever watched the show Black Mirror?
Yes, I've watched all Black Mirrors on Netflix.
They are
insane. Yeah, there's some
absolutely
good ones
insane.
There. Yeah, I just watched a movie one of it actually. Like. A week ago.
Is that the one where it's like choose your own adventure?
Yeah, you choose your
own. Bro, it's crazy.
Yeah. And it took me, when I was reading sort of the movie description, I didn't realize that that's what it was about. So at first I was like, why is it coming up with questions? Like, can I turn this off?
Yeah.
That's why it took me like halfway through the movie to realize like I'm picking what's going to happen in the movie.
That's like, I remember I looked into it and it's like, there's like 5 hours worth of content on it where so... Like, there's so many different options that it'll take that long. I'm away here. Oh! And, like, there's so many different options that, like, there's different endings and, like, you have to keep going back on that. It's honestly insane. I've never experienced anything like that.
Yeah. I wonder if, like, they'll make heaps of movies like that now.
I reckon there'll be a time where it's, like, virtual reality. But yeah. It's like a real life. It's basically video games, isn't it?
Yeah.
Virtual reality.
Like, but would that take ages to film that?
It'd have to.
Because obviously there's so many.
It'd have to. There's so many different options in that.
You think that'd be like, four times longer
pretty
than
sick,
the usual movie. But
I forgot about that until you brought it up.
Yeah.
That was pretty sick. I really enjoy the Black Mirror TV shows. They're so messed up.
Do you have
sometimes.
A favourite one?
I like the... Oh, no. What is way there? There's the one where... you know when she goes to that, she's like driving in the desert and she goes to that
like
museum? The museum?
That's my favorite one.
That's
Black
insane.
Museum is called, yeah.
Insane.
And he's going through all the stories like about the items in the museum.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Like,
and then she, like, spoiler alert for anyone who hasn't seen it, she ends up trapping him in there. And
because her dad's like in the museum, stuck in there or something. Yeah, it's
right, and that's, I remember
yeah, that's
I
my favorite one
that.
As well.
I was like, this is insane. Get you thinking too. And what about-
So creative, eh? Some of them.
There's some messed up ones too. Like,
yeah. Ugh. But then there's like the odd. I think I've only seen one sort of happy ending one.
There's one. What about the one where like everyone gets rated? It's like everyone has their own Uber.
Oh yeah, Uber I watched half of that one. That was a bit. Yeah,
it was like that was the first ever one I watched.
Like a social media sort of
which is the way it's going.
Imagine that. Hey, you look at someone.
There probably will be something like that in the future with like this metaverse stuff happening. Bro, the world's going online. I'm in trouble here. I'm in trouble. No, I'm not. Found him.
Oh no.
The big tight end down the middle.
No.
He's got the lead back. He has the lead back.
Not for long.
It's a clinic. This is an absolute clinic. Just give me the points, mate. I just want to go for points. Yeah, I found my play. You don't want this.
I actually want to win this game, mate.
Of course you do. It's not happening, baby. I got you on the rope, yeah. Got it. You're gonna have no time to call the play.
I've got it. It doesn't really matter.
Three, right? Two, one. Uh-oh. Yes!
Four.
Too long. Delay of game.
Oh.
We'll accept that. Yeah, hobbies. What do you got for us? What do you do in your spare time? What's Big Zano do when he's not walking down the beach, taking videos?
None of that. I'm into like sort of streetwear, so I'm different.
Streetwear?
Yeah, so like all my Jordans and that. I've got a bit of a shoe collection.
What ones do you have?
I've got a fair few ones, got some fours, got it's my ball. What else do I have?
Get him.
Yeah, just mainly the J's. I've got heaps of dunks, but
I didn't know that.
Dunks now are just like the most basic thing.
Do you just collect them or do you sell them on?
Nah, I just collect them mainly. I haven't sold them on yet. I don't have them.
You have any plans of selling or not?
Not really, because it's just like a little hobby, I guess, on the side.
How long have you been doing that for?
It's probably since like the start of this preseason, hey? Yeah. Because I was living near Newtown, and there was a shop that I sort of was just visiting a bit, and then I don't know. I feel like I bought one pair, and then just
become addicted to it.
Yeah, it was probably not the best financial decision, but
it could be the best financial decision.
Well, that's it. Yeah, like
bro, their value in shoes in the moment is unbelievable.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't wear them too much, so I guess hopefully they hold it.
I remember when we played up in Brisbane, we went to. I think it was Culture Kings. And then so you go in there to buy a pair of shoes and they literally like, so I think it was Jai and AJ and they went in to have a look for shoes, like for Jordan 1s, and they were like, nah, we're not going to sell them to you because they were so afraid of people like just selling them on.
Yeah.
And the boys were like, well, we will wear them out of the shop if this is what you want us to do. Oh no.
That's good, eh? That's so good. That's good by me. Yeah. But yeah, and then probably...
You can make a lot of money out of it.
Even just like movies, like I was sort of talking about, I just watch a fair few movies and that, so... Nothing too extravagant.
Nothing too crazy. Who have you been impressed so far? Like, you were talking about stretch earlier, but like in the preseason, we'll go back to like the preseason, obviously that's the hardest part of the year.
Yeah.
Physically. Was there anyone that really like stood out to you through the training, through maybe their leadership or their work ethic?
Someone that actually like really impressed me was probably Nighty. I think he was in rehab a fair bit, but like whenever I'd see him sort of in there, he was always just like going 100 miles per hour, like really going for it. So I think he impressed me a fair bit, just like his determination to sort of get back out there.
You can see in the performances he's putting in since being back.
100%. So there was definitely... Oh,
fumble!
Did he fumble?
Yeah!
Oh, no. Even like Josiah,
he impressed me a lot.
His fitness, man, like I swear, I've been playing with him for ages, and I swear I didn't even know he was fit until the preseason.
I remember doing one session, and I was absolutely hurting. And he goes, "Yeah, I think I just like showing that Travis, like that I'm actually hurting, and I'm actually like feeling tired." And I was like, "Bro, are you not really tired?" And I'm gone here.
Every morning I'd be like, "Oh, how do you feel too?" He's like, "Oh, I feel like so bad. Like I'm not ready for training." And then he just beat everyone.
Come out and
make it look easy and
run over. Just like, he's got the most lethal feet.
Yeah.
Like every game he maintains his power and his
every game we play now, like every team just yells like right foot step. So they all just must
have been doing the video on him.
Yeah, bro. But,
but you have to, bro. Good. Like
Yeah.
You gotta be ready for that stuff. Like people don't realise how important like preparation for that kind of stuff throughout the week.
Yeah. On like how much goes into it, hey.
Bro, it's so much that's awful for me.
Yeah, 100%, eh?
It's the little, just the little 1%ers that got to get you, try and get you that, the leg up, eh?
I'll get a chappy in here.
What's this? Is this third and second? Third and two. I got it. Move the chains!
That's all the questions, eh?
Yeah, we've absolutely flown through the questions here. This has been the easiest episode. We've been good.
Alright. Just a natural, mate.
But, the last 4 minutes. He's about to go up the middle. He's moved the chains again! Oh, this is so good. This is just some great football. Great football from the Carolina Panthers. They're gonna have a big season this year. Have you ever been overseas, like to America, to watch any of the games or any sport over there?
No, I haven't been to America. I'd love to. sort of mainly done Europe.
Yeah,
but
Europe's mad.
Yeah, so I've done a fair bit of Europe, but America's definitely a place I'd love to go.
Did you go and see like in England, see any of the EPL matches or anything like that?
No, we didn't. So we were over there, trained at the facilities there. I'm trying to think what facility we're at, but like we didn't even do that, and that's obviously, as I said before, I was like, I want to go back there.
Yeah.
In the off season.
Yeah. But EPL is I'd love insane. The atmosphere they have over there is honestly second to none. Yeah. I went over there in 14 for Aussie Schoolboys.
Yeah.
And we went and watched, so we were in Burnley. So like Burnley's like a little team and it's like a little town in England. And we went and watched them versus Southampton, which is like a bigger team. But like, oh no, I've thrown a pick.
Oh, that's big. Horrible. That's big. That's big.
Yeah, we went and watched them, right? And so the crowd was insane. Burnley ended up beating Southampton, who at the time were in the top four.
Yeah.
And so the crowd was going mental. And I remember we were walking out the game. There was like a little fence and separating all the Burnley fans that were leaving and all the Southampton fans that were waiting to get on their buses to go back to their home. Oh, and so the Burnley fans were absolutely giving it to the Southampton fans, like absolutely spraying them because it was a big win for them. And then so the Southampton fans broke the fence down, like pushed it. There was like a little white fence, broke it down. They've all jumped over, and there was this massive brawl. Like people were like dead set getting punched in the head. The cops all come running down the street, running in. Really? They got like the English.
It was like
got
the helmets.
Bro, it was insane. And we were like 17, 18, like, what?
Yeah.
I think there's even like, one of the boys got footage of it. It was honestly one of the most insane things I've ever seen in my life. But like, that's how intense like sport is. Like,
yeah, how passionate they are.
It's ridiculous. The atmosphere they have, bro, it's
sacked.
It's a big sack too.
But yeah, no, I'd love to, because I'm a massive like Boston Celtics fan, so
yeah.
It's probably number one on my bucket list is go TD Garden.
100%, bro, the NBA is so like, it's so cool.
Yeah.
They're passionate. Yeah. Americans are very, very passionate about their sports as well.
Who do you think will win the basketball?
Honestly, I reckon the Celtics will go close this year, bro. They absolutely towered up
Brooklyn.
That's a big play. They towered up Brooklyn.
I like Golden State, though. Yeah. I think
they've got the class, and they've got like, experience. Even if Steph's not performing, you got Poole on the bench.
Yeah, he's good, man. Hey, he's such like
unbelievable for him.
Yeah, I think.
And then Clay, and you got the best defender. I reckon he's the best defender in the game in Draymond Green. Get him!
Oh, go, he's through.
This sucks. Not the dive.
I dove into him, bro.
Oh, he's rushed for 200 yards. Yeah. Did you hear about the rumor that round one next year could be with, so it's us and Manly?
Yeah, someone was talking about that.
That'd be honestly.
What?
What's he doing?
What is
he
doing?
The game's glitching. Bro, they don't want me to win.
Bro, why didn't he get up from running? He just fell back down.
Bro, I reckon that'd be so sick to go over there and play in America. I reckon it'd be big for the game too.
Yeah, it'd be awesome, hey. Yeah, someone was telling me about that. I didn't hear about it until sort of just recently. But yeah. I was like, that'd be so, like, that'd just be an awesome experience.
It would be. It'd be insane.
Yeah. What do you think, the crowds would be like there? Do you reckon they'd get around
it? Remember they played, I remember England. He's won. What? His clock management has not been there.
And
I've taken the dub. I'm 2-1 now on my own show. Let's go. Distract them with the conversation and they can't maintain the game.
I was full in driver's seat there too.
You would have marched me down the field. Yeah, but yeah, I remember, so they took, I think it was a game over in Denver between England and New Zealand a couple of years ago. And then, so like Denver's like, I think it was Denver. It was the place where it's like the air is thinner at the stadium, the Mile High Stadium or something like that. And then I was talking to, I remember, because Tommy played in that game, and then because I was at the Dragons at the time, James Graham came back and he was like, for the first 5 minutes or the first 10 minutes, sweet. And then as soon as like, your body is just begging for oxygen, like
really?
The altitude up there.
Yeah, different.
And like, it's like a different hurt on the field. Like the boys were struggling, it was hot in the sun.
Yeah.
And like, cause that's a place, like the high altitude, that's a place where like all the records for like the longest field goal, well it was there, I don't know if it's
yeah,
there
yeah.
Like cause the altitude, even like, the you just let the ball like, fly, yeah.
Yeah, right. Yeah, I didn't think of that, hey.
Bro, it's like, I'd love to go over there and play a game. I can be so sick. But I've just tagged you up on a game. It was never a doubt. Another win, 21-14. Great game, mate.
Good game, mate.
It was good to have you on the show, mate. Thanks for coming on.
Thanks for having me.
Good luck with the rehab, and hopefully you get to see you out in first grade soon, bro. That'd be massive for you.
Cheers, brother. Yeah, it'd be good.